invite you now to speak to the Lord with us in prayer. And I've asked two of the students to come and pray with us. First of all, let me introduce to you Victoria Armstrong. She's 8. And it's her first time at music school this year, and she's going to pray first. And then after that, we have Johnny Bird. It's his 11th time at music school. He's been there every year. So please join with us now in prayer as these two students lead us. Let's pray.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for music camp. Thank you for everyone who helped to make it special for us. And thank you for all the newcomers that came to music camp. Amen.
Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us here once again to celebrate this year's Music School Festival. We've been able to feel your presence with us during the week in COVID, and we hope that you will continue to be with us this weekend. Bless all students and staff who will be taking part. May some of us see the blessing from the music and drama being presented be challenged in some way. Your name, we ask this. Amen.
I would ask you now then to join with us in prayer as we sing the choruses printed on the programme. We do sing the words that are the correct words. And we use these words in worship to our Lord. Up by feet, I by adoring, bending lower, lower still. Giving up my all to follow, just to do my master's will. Giving up my all to follow, just to do my master's will. Let's sing together in worship and in praise of our Lord at this time. Welcome to the 10th anniversary festival of our annual music school. It's very good to see you all here, and I hope that as you join together with us in worship and in prayers, as you join together with us in the enjoyment of the music that we bring to you this evening, the drama items of the timbrel displays and so on, that you really will enjoy yourself with us this evening. I want to say a number of different things at this stage. First of all, let me bring you a very important word. It's the chorus that we've already sung. At thy feet I bow adoring. We've been doing some of that during the week at music school, and we do it again tonight. And that chorus is our theme for this evening. At thy feet I bow adoring, bending lower, lower still, giving up my all to follow, just to know my master's will. And you'll find that chorus repeated a number of different times this evening. in a number of different ways. And each time you hear the music, please think of the words. They're our theme for this evening, and they're also our theme for tomorrow evening in the Salvation Meeting. Well, you've already heard the Avon bring us a number of pieces of music, and we're going to listen to them again as they bring us an overture which is entitled Excelsior. You can see in your programme that it's written by Dudley Bright, and it was specially commissioned for the Youth Spectacular at the 1990 International Congress at Wembley. It features a number of tunes. It features The Words Forgot, Happy Day, At Thy Feet I Bow Adoring, Glory to His Name, which we used last year, World Army Youth, which I'll mention in a moment, and Keep the Old Flag Flying. The song World Army Youth was also used at the Youth Spectacular, again written by Dudley, and it contains these words. World Army Youth knows the way to a world where God's will is done. World Army Youth shows the way to Jesus, God's world-redeeming Son. I hope that this evening, and I hope it will not just be this evening, but I do hope that this evening, that your young people, our young people, will show you the way to worship, to service of the Lord, to following His will. Well, here is the A-Band bringing us the overture Excelsior, written by Dudley Bright, and they are conducted by their conductor and our musical director, Julian Bright. Thank you. Please welcome. thrill being able to stand in front of a band that plays like that, in that style of music, and to be able to conduct a piece that was written by your brother. And for me, that that last item was a particular highlight of the festival. We've only just got started. Now let me introduce to you the Camp Chorus. This year, again, under the leadership of songster leader Wilfred Piper, and they're going to sing two songs to us. The first one is called March On by Graham Press, who is a Salvationist living in Australia. And the second one is written by Barry Gott, and it's called Come To Me. And it's based on a portion of scripture as indicated on your programme, Matthew chapter 11, 28-30. So the two songs, March On and Come To Me. Perhaps you'd like to welcome the chorus and their leader, Wilfred Piper. Thank you.
It's very much a teaching task to introduce to you the second band that we have at the music camp, and that is the B band, sort of to the right down here in the front. And this band this year has been under the tutelage and direction of Bamzan David Padukan from the Temple, and John Corey and myself have also been privileged to share and work along there. And it's been a very rewarding week by all accounts, and we've had great fun, and we've had great fellowship with the young people in that particular band. You may be under this apprehension that the bands are graded A and B, but in actual fact, the A band is A for Assembly Hall, because that's where they rehearse, and the B band is B for Basement, because we rehearse in the basement of the college there at Co-Rail. And when you hear them, you will know why. But I would ask you to welcome the B band under the leadership of David Kabukin. Please, if you would, at this moment. Because it's the 10th anniversary, lots of surprises are happening, and we've decided to give the musical director a treat, and he's going to conduct the B-band in the Festival March to Caledonia.
That's quite splendid, and it would be remiss at this point if we didn't mention the fact that
as well as John and David and Philip working away with this band. There are a number of the lads who play in this particular group here who have given very valuable service all week by giving up their free time to coach and tutor and then break down parts and all the things that are necessary. So we say a very special thank you to them and a word from our sponsor.
Award, which goes to Portman. Now, this is an award that requires quite a special person to win, because we watch them very closely during the week, and I know tonight's particular winner won it by a long, long way above everyone else, and then put it up the marks. And Julian's not going to present it.
And the Mark Bassett Award, which is presented for deportment, goes to Stephen Moore.
Bye.
mention once again to you, as I've done many years in the past, that during the week at music school, this time at Gloria Inn, as we've been enjoying our new setting, we don't just make music, we also have a spiritual side to the whole thing. And the spiritual side of the whole thing has become very, very important. In the last few days, we have met together each morning and each evening for prayers. Last Sunday, we also went to the local Presbyterian church. We've also had open air meetings and the like. And now, as we come towards the end of this week, the spiritual content also continues. Thank you very much to the drama group and Emily for that piece of action. And that same Jesus who was alive then is still alive today. That same Jesus who was alive then and who directed people in their service for him is the same Jesus who is alive today and directs and motivates us at our music school. So the chorus are now going to come to sing to us. They're going to sing us two songs. The first one is a new setting of old words. Christ is all, yes, all in all, my Christ is all in all. I think sometimes we have a dislike of new settings of old words, but I think that you will very much enjoy this particular setting. I know I do, and I hope that you will enjoy this new setting of Herbert Howard Booth's words. And that'll be followed by an American Salvationist rendition of Unto the King. towards our theme, at thy feet I bow adoring, bending lower, lower still, giving up my all to follow, just to do my master's will. I want to bring to you just now a Bible reading from the Psalms. And you'll find two of the verses of that Bible reading on the front of your programme. It's Psalm 95. Psalm 95. And I'm going to read the first 7 verses. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is the great God, the great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to him. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, the flock under his care. Amen. I shall simply have to refer to them as the A band because I can't think of another word beginning with A. But they are just now going to bring us a piece of music written by Robert Bedhead called Quintessence. It brings to us the essentials of Australian salvationism. It describes for us the vastness of the Australian continent, and tells us something of the development of the Salvation Army from the Christian mission days right through to the army of today. At one point you will hear two of those early pioneer salvationists shouting the gospel message in one of those early open-air meetings. But it does introduce to us again our theme of At Thy Feet I Bow Adoring, a chorus which was in fact written by two Australian salvationists. Enjoy the piece of music, listen out for that chorus in particular, and here are the A-band playing to us Quintessence.
Thank you. Thank you.
band, which was our learners band. The bad news is that we don't have a learners band this year. The good news is, though, that most of those children who were playing in the C band last year and who were having great difficulty in blowing anything but their nose have now graduated into this B band. Some of them who could only play one or two notes this time last year are now holding important parts in this band. And that's a tremendous credit to not just the people at the music school, but people at your own cause, people who spend time after time, night after night, with many of these young people, training them, teaching them in the rudiments of music. And Davey has particularly benefited from all that training that goes on throughout the whole year this week. This band, and now I'm going to play to you two items. First of all, we have the selection from the John Larson and John Gowan's musical Spirit, arranged by Ray Stenhallen, and then an arrangement of the song This Little Light of Mine. Would you like to welcome them back, please?
composed to a prayer from that band. As you're all very much aware, John Clark did a lot of hard work at music schools and is well worth remembering in this way. I hand over to Julian now to present the award.
John Clark Award is somebody who has served valiantly in this band for several years now, and this year, as usual, has held the performance section together. John Clark Award to Philip Norton.
Someone says here's the daughter. And now we come to that part of the evening where that so you think BT is waiting on? Is everyone's waiting on? And you want to tell you understand it? And we want to present the awards. This evening we have quite a few awards to get to. We've already presented two awards. And we do it in the usual fashion. First of all, you wake up Julian. And the first award. And I'm going to find him. I'm going to try and make him find himself. He's my turtle. Is our award for the best newcomer, and as always, we have three nominations. Our nominations are as follows: we have Simon Arthur, Victoria Armstrong, and Jonathan Wiley.
Thank you.
very exciting evening to unearth by listening to the entire school as they bring us a song. It is a song, as you can see in your programme, called Day of Jubilee. And on this 10th anniversary, it seems quite appropriate. So the school will now assemble in preparation for our singing. Thank you. We hope that this evening you've been entertained, that you've been blessed,